Hi, I'm Satish Raj Kasireddy, and I made one of the films in Shor Se Shuruaat, which is an omnibus project between seven directors directing seven short films. And it's based on a similar concept, on a common theme called Shor in Hindi, and which means noise.
हो गया है वजन के हिसाब से फंदा बनता है, छोटा बड़ा हो गया तो गर्दन तुरंत नहीं टूटती।
एंड माय इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ शोर वाज प्रीटी मच इनसाइड द हेड काइंड ऑफ नॉइज। सो व्हाट वन गोज थ्रू व्हेन समबडी गोज थ्रू सम काइंड ऑफ अ ट्रॉमा, सम काइंड ऑफ साइकोटिक डिप्रेशन ड्यू टू सम इंसिडेंट दैट हैज हैपेंड इन दैट पर्सनस लाइफ। So I try to deal with that kind of noise inside the head and what you need to do to get out of it, which is mostly like a self-help which you need, which is what I feel, that one needs self-help to get out of any kind of trauma, any kind of depression. And also at the same time, using the same medium, I thought of including the social media, which has become like quite chaotic at this point of time, like in today's day and age, how it's kind of in a way ruling our lives day in and out. Like we're constantly on our phones or laptops or iPads everywhere, like, you know, so we're so involved in social media. So I want to bring out the noise of social media when it actually does something to someone in a good way or a bad way, that you need to figure out in the film. And that's what Mia I Am is about, which is my short film. And I've shot this completely in the northeastern part of India, in Shillong and Cherrapunji chiefly, since I feel the film required that kind of space, the area where somebody can live in solitude, as well as the beauty of that place, which could be haunting at the same time. And it's something which is quite unexplored in India at this point of time, I feel. And I've not been to film school or any such film education space, but what I've learned is learned while I was working, and most of the time it has been with Imtiaz. So I worked with Imtiaz for like 7 years now. My last film with him was Rockstar, and I started working with him on Jab Vi Met. So like, you know, in a very strange way, Imtiaz has this way of teaching you stuff where he will never let you know that he's teaching you something. And he's like a great friend who would actually take care of you, at the same time would never let you realize that. Who would actually take your case also would never let you realize. So it's a very tough person to work with, honestly, in a way, where he knows even before you say something, he would probably know what you're trying to say. So let's say, like, you know, sometimes it becomes a little tough to work with people like that. So you need to be smarter than him to understand what he wants and how you deliver. So which eventually is making you smarter and making you on your to be on your feet all the time. So which is what he keeps doing, and definitely his intentions were great. The reason why he opted to mentor me, because he had an option to mentor anybody, so he chose me to make a film. And he was the one who in fact suggested me also to start working on my own scripts and all that, since I've been working with him for a long time. So I used to share ideas and stuff with him, and he used to always be like, excitement bahut acha hai, but you have to execute it, you have to write it, you have to shoot it, there are the process that you know, so you have to do it. Ideas in the head are of no use.
This is where we belong.
Honestly, I don't know why, what could have come across his mind, the reason why he chose me, but the way I've worked with him, with Imtiaz, has been like quite there, like, you know, giving in everything. So as an assistant director also, like, I used to given whatever I had, and I used to believe that if you're not giving everything that you have, there'll be something that you'll miss out on, and that will reflect in a film. And a film, Imtiaz used to say, every time he used to say two things. First, always read your script every day before you go for a shoot. So every day, keep reading your script, keep reading your script, because something or the other, you it will click, something you want to change or something that you want to make better. So don't leave it till the last minute, till you have canned the film. So keep your eyes wide open, your mind open, before you take that shot and say okay to it. So, like, you know, till the last minute, you have the chance of improving. And then he used to also say that once you've canned the film, you can't change anything. So for lifelong, every time you switch on your laptop or TV or computer or whatever and watch the film. And if you've not done your 100%, it'll pinch you, it'll hurt you, that you're not given your best. So that's something that has stayed with me. And I always feel like, whether it's like any kind of a shoot, so I always feel that you have to give in your 100%, walk out of it as if you're coming out of a war. Either you're dead or you've killed someone and walked out of it. So it's that's this feeling.
I know something about you.
My criteria of making anything, selecting my technical crew to actors to anybody in the film, especially work related, it has to be utmost honesty towards the film. If you love the film, then only come on board. I'm not offering you any money, I'm not offering you any kind of a special status in life, or I'm not promising you like, you know, I'll give you some work or something. It's only if you love the film, please come and work on the film. You could be the most talented person in the world, but if your heart is not there, then I can't have you on board. So that's been like my foot rule forever. And which also is Imtiaz's. I feel that's where I'm also learning from. So everybody needs to justify why they're a part of the film. So if the actors are not suiting the role, they're not. And especially in this film, since all my cast is from Shillong and Chirapunji, it was not a conscious decision in the beginning, because living in Bombay, like, you live in a small well, a pool of talent, and you feel that that's the world. And from there only you try to figure out your actors, your musicians, everybody. And for me, the biggest challenge was my actress, the girl who acted, and music. So might as well pack your bag and go to the place where you want to shoot, right? So Shillong, since I've never been there, so it was also exciting to visit that place as a tourist also. So my DOP Anirudh Garbyal and myself, we both left. We kind of figured out some connection, friend, and borrowed a bike for like 10 days, a Bullet. And we went on that, from cafes to bars to, like, you know, the whole hilly areas to Chirapunji, everywhere. Actress wise, most of them didn't, none of them actually wanted to shave off their head. So that's the reason why good actors also didn't want to do the film. So we were sitting, and this guy whom I had connected, who has also played a part in the film as Gino. So he's a brilliant musician. He's a school teacher as well as a musician who was a beautiful singer. So I had seen his performance. So I connected with him, then I met him, then I asked him if he wants to act and all that. So he introduced me to a couple of other composers and, like, you know, actors and all. So this girl happened to be the composer's friend's friend, who helped me a lot in casting, in getting locations for free and all of that. So I told him this is the character. Then he suggested, there's this friend of mine, she's a photographer, why don't you just meet her. So I'm like, okay, I'll meet her, but I'm leaving tomorrow. So he's like, no, she can't meet today because she's not in town. So I'm like, okay. So then we pushed our trip by a day. So that one day made the whole film, actually. So sometimes you have to take those calls, even though you're in a very tight budget. You are like, you have to take those calls as a filmmaker, that, okay, let me push this envelope a bit. So that's what I feel we need to keep doing. Like, ek chance aur lete hain, thoda aur aage badhte hain. Like, you know, let's push ourselves. So, and that's when I met Baya in a cafe, and I explained the story to her, narrated the film. And then she heard the story, and then the only question she had was, so she held her hair and she was like, she has nice, beautiful, long hair she had. So she held her hair and she's like, do I have to chop my hair? So I was like, yes. She just looked at it as if she was looking at it for the last time. So she just looked at it and like, okay. So, like, you know, these small things that makes you feel that she's there. And that's the moment I told her that, you're on, like, we'll be shooting soon.